Hello, today we are meeting Ziria and Erkriel. They are people who eat anything which is radiating, like uranium sources, power lines, and some other things. So please tell everyone who are you, where you come from, and actually what kind of beings are you? Ziria.
Of course, we come on this planet and we are not humans in genetically, in spiritually, in soul. We come from radiation dimension. Our home is radiation dimension. We not have home. We not have home like some planet.
Like on one planet.
Mm-hmm. We not have any planet like our home because our home is radiation dimension. But in way from radiation dimension, we travel all space and we meet a lot of alien civilizations. We meet a lot of another beings. In one incarnation was a full incarnation in the planet Antario Aereus.
Mm-hmm. So you say radiation dimension. But this planet is what kind of dimension?
This is material dimension, like physical dimension, mm-hmm. basically. And radiation dimension, this is dimension of elementary particles. Like
of elements of nature. Elements of nature. All elements of nature, they was born from radiation dimension. Radiation dimension, usually this is from what begin all absolute. This is like big bang, big mm-hmm. explosion. From this radiation dimension was this big explosion.
Mm-hmm. But material things are also...
Yes, they have origin from this dimension. Mm-hmm.
So radiation is like
most old, like parent of all this another dimensions.
This is elements of nature from who was born all another elements of nature.
So material dimension is more dense.
Yes. Uh-huh. Yes, you can say that. Mm-hmm. It's a radiation dimension, very subtle dimension, very.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so actually you are ETs. Mm-hmm. We can say that.
Of course.
And when you discovered that?
When discovered?
Yes.
No, I usually remember all from birth. Of course, my consciousness started awakening. After some accidents, after that my consciousness started awakening even more stronger. But even before this, I have dreams and all memories. They started like slowly return to us, to me. Mm-hmm. And we know this, that we are not humans. We even this is even noticeable. This is very noticeable. We always separate from society. We are social, like. We always was all
outside.
People around hate us, like mm-hmm. they because we not like them.
Mm-hmm.
And we of course we always separate, come to nature more far from and not contact with humans.
Mm-hmm. So it means that humans react to you in some special way.
Of course, there is most percent of humanity react to us negatively because they have. Program radiophobia in mind,
mm-hmm.
but there is a very little percent of people who are open-minded, and these mm-hmm. people react positively.
No, now we started this realize and mm-hmm. see because after interviews, after we come in public and we see that not all humanity bad, and we start to see that still have good people who which open mind mm-hmm. and because before of course was bad experience like bad memories and from childhood this was always punishment, always pressure, always. No, I don't know how
negative emotions.
Mm-hmm.
Very negative emotions.
So maybe those people had negative emotions in them, and when you were close, they reacted.
Mm-hmm.
So you cleanse them. You are cleaners, yeah?
Mm-hmm. This is true. Partly. Radiation, mm-hmm. Partly, because radiation is so true. When they contact with us, they cannot hold inside what they hide.
Mm-hmm.
This is bad or good thing, they cannot hold radiation, like push them all outside and they like show all the disgusting or good thing or mm-hmm. bad thing, they all showed outside, mm-hmm. how they
so
in
they
real
are transparent.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Because you know, for humans, for humanity, this is most scared fact. They most scared show all they have inside. In real.
Because people are programmed with fear. And fear. When you like touch them, the fear comes out.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Okay. So what is your origin? You were born in Chernobyl, yes?
My past.
Mm-hmm.
You mean in this planet?
This planet,
in this incarnation.
In this incarnation, I was born in Chernobyl 26 April 1986,
mm-hmm.
correct?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
In a night explosion, 1 hour, 23 minutes, 40 seconds. And I remember all very good, all details that was in this moment.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, before we come together on planet, this we lived little different ways come, and this is not important to describe, but my part was even before, because one my part come in Halley Comet, one my part come a little earlier and was inside reactor number 4 Chernobyl nuclear power plant. And
mm-hmm.
I was less like incarnation of Chernobyl nuclear power plant. And this was what analogy with Phoenix. I was like
mm-hmm.
born myself. This is like I like born from fire from this explosion. And
mm-hmm.
I very good remember that I was on beton and you know,
concrete.
On
yes.
concrete, and after that I look in the starry sky. First my breeze, this was very painful, completely different atmosphere and very smooth in eyes, I cannot see anything. And first that I see ventilation, this tube from my native, my favorite. And I see very beautiful starry sky, so bright starry sky, and I see this, of course, I now far from home, from space far, and this is very beautiful. I see this Halley Comet in this moment.
Mm-hmm.
I see this like part of me, and this was very pleasant. And even before born, I remember all details that what happens in Chernobyl nuclear power. I feel all people who was here. I hear their voice, and in Vishu 4, I don't know how this translate. In operator center,
mm-hmm.
I remember all who was here. I even look at them even before this my born. I like look at them and I know them very good. Like in one person, Valery Khadimchuk, I personally was contact with him. Was astral contact with him, and
mm-hmm.
he was disappear. I know where he now live. He not die. He lived in another dimension. He was transferred in another dimension. This was because of me. I in this moment, like when I touch him, I don't know. I like open portal in this moment, or maybe this not because I've touched him, because of my born was, and he exactly was in this place and very good locality, and he moved in this dimension. But he moved in this dimension not only because of accidental, because I chose him before, and this was. Not only because of accident, but because of I before choose him.
Mm-hmm. And you were born in Czech Republic.
Yes.
And from the childhood you had also this kind of experiences.
Of course, from childhood, like big separation from society, and I could always feel that I'm different from all around. I did not enjoy loud companies. I did not enjoy smoking, drinking, alcohol, these kind of habits. I always tried to stay in nature and meditate, these
mm-hmm.
kind of things. Look for energetic places, for example.
But of course you understand how this hard, and when you especially from childhood, and especially very hard to keep a distance from this society, especially
yeah.
in schools. This is
of
almost,
course, in the few, there were tests for me, of course.
This for us were very big tests. For you, what this was?
Well, of course, very big test, but more important that I was able to find like my true self and awake.
Mm-hmm.
About power lines.
Of course, I love energetic places to like irradiate under power lines or geopathogenic zones, actually.
Oh, you know, because where you live, you have this a lot of power lines exactly in this place, and this is your favorite place where you
meditate.
Go always meditate and sit under this power lines. Mm-hmm. And this is like charged organism. For
so
me,
it's
the same, identical. Mm-hmm. Or especially, you know, very good, not just power lines, a pyramidal power lines. They have very strong power field.
The big high voltage. Yes.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. They, when you have pyramidal, they even more concentrate energy inside. When you stand like this and you all body very fast charges, very pleasant. Because when you not have, for example, when we not have radioisotopes to eat, this was only one way that we can charge ourselves, like survive.
Mm-hmm. And when you don't charge yourself with radiation for a long time, what happens? You feel hungry or...?
Very hungry feeling, very weak, not have energy for anything. And of course, in very strong, like, you know, martial character even awakened more, like for all around.
Your planet before this incarnation, where is it located?
Aereo Santaria.
This was named Aereo Santaria. This is not planet, this is two planets. Planet
Arisian
stem, three suns, two suns very close to Antaria, one sun very more far. This was three planet. They mention X2Z 48, X2Z 48. I don't know how this translate.
Okay.
This is nine name of the dimension. Enter from the dimension, and we was incarnated. Erkriel was in Ontario. I was in Aereos, but we meet very fast. Like we only was because our parts like little split. And fall down his part in this planet and I in another. Aereos, this was little planet. I don't know how compare with Earth, this is very hard, but this never mind. But Aereos was very little planet, which blue atmosphere, very beautiful purple stones. Amazing, like charaite, you know, this mineral. Very native mineral, because I remember the stones very good. A lot of plasma lakes, tritium lakes, was very beautiful cave, I remember, where we spent time together. Also in Ontario was more bigger planet. They have, if from outside look, they have purple atmosphere, but inside is very light planet, like sand color, orange more.
Mm-hmm.
And in this planet, less plants. If in Aereos more plants, like forests, and Ontario a little less plants, more rocks, like caves, and this kind of things. Also in connection with this planet, in Ontario was flying mountains, because this is part of a ring. Aereos have ring, like Saturn.
Mm-hmm.
And they very long time ago was almost to each other, but they stop by gravitation of these stars.
Mm-hmm.
And this part of ring, they little come in atmosphere of Aereos, of Ontario, and the flying rocks still have very amazing gravitation, this anomaly place. And Aereos have this ring too. Aereos inhabit warriors, guardians, warriors.
Uh-huh.
Ontario was mostly with scientists, guardians too, like.
Mm-hmm.
And Ontario was more higher than Aereos. Aereosians was more little, like, for example, I don't know.
Smaller.
Mm-hmm. For example, if like in figure speech, 1 meter Aereosians, Ontarians in like almost 2 meters, like difference.
Mm-hmm.
But this is very figure speech because I don't know how to compare with human size.
And what kind of beings are there? Like, are they similar to us, to humans?
No, completely different. Completely different. They was organic. This is true. But by the way, organic life forms they very rare in all absolute. More than 95% of all inorganic life form.
Mm-hmm.
And they was organic life form, but their chemical compounds was completely different. A lot of chemical elements even not have in periodic table in planet Earth. Only few elements was, for example, definitely was inert gases.
Mm-hmm.
Krypton, xenon was more good for them, for breeze, but argon was toxic. They cannot tolerate argon. And I remember when we was in one war together, this was like trap from anti-life creature, and my command of area sense, and they was die because they put this gas argon and they started to die. And we started realizing this moment that we not die from this gas. We normal breathe this gas, and our physiology even in these bodies, extraterrestrial bodies, even was different from them because of our origin, different of course. For us, of course, ideal not argon breeze. For us, ideal now in before to breeze radon. Radon, turon, turon, this is product of the same thorium, radon, product of the same radium. Radon, of course, most. But, on radon, like functional all our body. This is all very neat for us. Here and even before.
Mm-hmm. And tell me, this war was against whom?
Against whom? This against an anti-life matter. This is creatures, they can be witch out bodies, but witch out bodies, they cannot exist in space because they are very weak to radiation. And they created, of course, bodies and ships.
So why they wanted to fight against you?
Because they
fight against Antaria Ariosians, because this is one, if not only one civilization, but one and most powerful civilization who was not under their influence. And when they not under influence, they try to
suppress.
So suppress. Of course, was a lot of союзники, how is it? No, friendly, another friendly civilization,
allies.
For example, vegans from Vega, mm-hmm. But they was not organic life form, but they all against us, this anti-life, this, in this galaxy, this all was. But we not only in this galaxy travel, no, like, not in this, I mean, in this Antario areas, we travel in another galaxies, we travel in another universe, mm-hmm. A lot of us traveling. Even which out body, in which body we travel, because we have spaceship. By the way, spaceships in areas, Ontario, in Ontario, they are born in Ontario. Spaceship have a biological origin. This is spaceship, not man-made. This is living creatures. Only Ariosians create like shield from them, protection. They little looks technical outside, but this is completely live creatures. They have intellect, they have feelings, they can speak. And Antarias most always they work with the spaceships from childhood. They can communicate with them. Mm-hmm. This is the same like horse in human, but mm-hmm. in good sense, of course. Like
they live in harmony together.
In harmony, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And of course they help each other and they fly in the spaceship. It's very interesting, completely different from humans.
Mm-hmm. So these two planets are not in our galaxy, they are in different dimensions.
Even dimension different, because this is very far from here.
Okay, so what is the difference in DNA between you and other people?
Of course there is from birth different DNA, different type of DNA that is has predisposition for radiation.
Mm-hmm.
It contains information about how ingest radionuclides, how to use them in all body. How to build body, of course.
Mm-hmm. When we arrive, of course, this is all information was to. But of course, we here use for build body, like analogies of living creatures here. We always doing this when we incarnate on some planets or when we even create shape. For example, not physical but energetical, but completely visible. We always copy from
like the planet we visit actually mm-hmm. the form that lives there, these inhabitants. We copy their external look, like we look human, but DNA is completely different.
Completely different in chemical compounds too. For example, for our bodies need completely different chemical elements. We can use, of course, chemical elements that human body use because we have similar, but these elements not bring to us anything good, and for building, of course, need another chemical elements. For us, this is like problems, a little problem for us. But we know how found these chemical elements. Mm-hmm. This is a good thing. And I have two blood properties, very unusual from birth, because I before was poisoned, very strong. And I was like adopted,
mm-hmm.
and put in experimental from 10, 21 years, and they try to, they very often put me some nasty things in food, especially to try some injections, some try to poison. I feel very bad after that, and after in one moment in 2003 was a case after them, after their what they doing. I was in ambulance, 80% blood lost. Doctor tells with this blood loss cannot survive any human. And this was help from my friends, Ontario Airways. They bring me blood that from my past incarnation. And this blood completely recovered my body very fast. It's like almost 2 liters blood they fluid me inside. This is was dark blood, little red, like black. And second was blue blood. And mm-hmm. they give me these two blood, I remember very good.
So we have black and blue blood.
Mm-hmm.
Blue means that a lot of copper.
Copper?
Yeah, because copper is green, blue.
I think this is not only because of this, can be in different mm-hmm. compounds, because a lot of rare age elements, for example, yttrium, thulium, lutetium, europium, they to create this color.
Mm-hmm.
This is very needed, like chemical elements for me, especially for us too.
Uh-huh. So in 2003, those two friends appeared before you.
This is was second contact. First contact with them was even more earlier in 2000 year,
mm-hmm.
15 November, mm-hmm. 30 or 50. I don't remember exactly in this diapason. Mm-hmm.
And they showed to you in the human body. Or in light body, or
in their real body, how they was look before, mm-hmm. How I remember them.
Mm-hmm.
This is was.
But they were physical.
Mm-hmm. Only I was teleported. How I understand for a few seconds, because I remember was one person who sees this, and mm-hmm. he told that I disappeared in a few seconds, and no, for me this was like 5 minutes
mm-hmm.
talking with them.
And what happened? How did you feel after this? What after changed what? In you?
After the blood transfusion?
After those meetings with your friends?
Of course, even before my consciousness was memory, but after this was pushing and I completely start to remember what I doing here.
I
always know what is that I'm not human, but I started to understand why I here.
What was the difference in your feeling, in your consciousness, after those meetings with them?
Of course,
so the awakening, mm-hmm. what kind of experience was your awakening?
Awakening was very interesting. First, this was memories, my world vision started to change, but most stronger changes, like very fast, appear after blood transfusion. After this moment, I remember a few hours, 1-2 hours maximum, was these changes when I lying in this moment. I remember how my body would mutate inside completely, like cleaning, like all this dirty blood this was before, poison blood. This is like different blood and completely change all genetic inside, like improve. No, not change, I improve. I feel completely changes. I remember very beautiful pictures behind, like on ice,
mm-hmm.
like little hallucinogenic pictures was because this was very strong changes, and I remember unusual, very in front of ice fractals was particles. I see this all very strong. Like I remember before even feel radiation, but I not understand. But after I even started feel even more stronger, and I started see these particles more. And of course, my character changed very strong. If before was very disappointed, like suicide, like tolerated character, I tolerate all what they doing with me, like not have choice, and I don't know what doing. I completely disappointed was, and after that, my character changed completely opposite and completely like martial, aggressive to them, like completely cannot tolerate anymore them. Was very cunning, of course, character.
You could make strong decisions.
I cannot tell this straight to them because I understand. I feel that I need wait moment, and I live every day in lying. Every word what I told them this was lying. I tell one thing and I doing completely opposite thing. I always lying them because this was impossible survive without lying. And finally, after some time, I escaped in Moscow for 4 years. This was this chance for me was escape. Mm-hmm. This was very good, like accident. How is this?
Incident. Coincidence.
Coincidence. Very good. In I able to escape. But even when I escape, they. This is 4 years what I was, 3 years definitely, maybe not four, but 3 years what I lived, they terrorized me. They tried to found me, they found address, they call in police. After police, because when this was their mistake, they call in police and Ukrainian police and tell that, I escaped, maybe like, maybe in Moscow against will or something like this, tell about me that they saw beautiful parents and like I against will. And after that, I talk in which police person, I tell them all what they do with me and why I escape. And they, of course, after that, have problems after that. Mm-hmm. They, after that, stop communicating.
And your memories of your planet before?
Different than there. I remember more slowly, but...
But we have the same.
I have these visions, these memories, they appear usually in lucid dreams. I see visions about these planets, I can see these inhabitants. But really, I still don't have completely fully, like...
You like more awakened. Remember us than...
I remember our life together mostly than all around.
Yeah, he like his memory more peaceful, because he like more remember...
He was not a warrior.
No, he was not warrior, of course, but I first remember wars because I was in very bad, like, this 21 years and was in very bad around me, and first my memories too awakening, like, martial memories and mm-hmm. of wars and about anti-life and all this come, of course, most first this come to me it's about us together, but in which this comes to this worse kind of things because this was probably this was important for me. For him this was not important. For me this was important. Remember.
Mm-hmm. I inside basically try to leave all these bad memories because they're not useful in future life. Most important is to keep positive things inside. Of course.
And of course, but in experience need. Remember experience. Mm-hmm. Especially because the war still not end. In mm-hmm. this planet especially.
And in 2012 you met Stuart Sverdlov, yes? Mm-hmm. So, say something about it.
This was interview?
This was interview when we, like when I first found out about Ziria and her similar abilities, and we actually, after this interview, started communicating with each other. Mm-hmm. This was like a start of our...
friendship.
Thanks to the interview. Because I, when this interview doing, I not know why I doing this, but I feel this very important. And I started to realize that I doing this because of I meet Erkriel, my husband. Mm-hmm. This is was most important reason for this. Of course, this was seek for donation money because I was in very hard situation. Was incident which fees be 12 May 2012. All very bad things and I was my life was in danger from mother ex husband and. They want to me deport in Ukraine if they know I cannot go here, I can even not have place to live in. And I was completely in danger. I first go on this interview for this reason, but I feel, but this is not because of this reason, I feel something else very important. Mm-hmm. We meet each other because of this. And first my desire was to immigrate in United States because a lot of friends was and like more, I don't know, I feel very good about this country and I wanted to go in United States first. But our plans changes when we meet each other and we decide to live in Czech Republic, of course, and a lot of things, like because of course closer, and in United States I was denied visa one time, and we decided not need to try anymore, and we found later found very beautiful location to uranium mines, and just for us enough of course now, for now.
What kind of living organisms on the earth, on this earth, are closest to you?
Of course not humans, I understand.
So what?
How is it?
Mushrooms. Very much similar, because they too have ability to live, not, they don't need sun, they can live for example only from radiation.
A lot of mushrooms, they, this is really what we analyze, only one living organism in planet Earth who have most genetic, because we, when we incarnate in this planet, we take the genetic to, from mushrooms. If you know mushrooms in real, only in this planet, so primitive creature like looks. You know, this is like mushrooms that you see, this is not mushroom, this is only плодовое тело, like fruit body. In real, mushroom underground, this like intellectual organism on the underground, but in this planet they look like this. We know so much civilization who have a completely humanoid body, and this is mushrooms, this is not humans.
But intellectual mushrooms, that ability, very high abilities.
And of course we think mushrooms most closest to us, because this is only one living organism who can live by radiation, they say. They can use radiation like food. They can eat, for example, I know my own experience, I see this personally, and nuclear fuel elements from nuclear reactor, very high radioactivity after working with reactors, they have not only uranium, another product of decay.
The waste.
Like waste, so-called waste. And and I see in this nuclear fuel elements grow niger, Aspergillus niger, this is plissen, mushroom, this is primitive mushroom. They eat nuclear fuel, they not only eat because of radiation, but they really would eat radioisotopes. This is very interesting. This is so, but I know in planet have even some kind of bacteria who can live on very strong radiation, but they... this is a little different. We now talk about organisms like more development organism. From development to organisms is mushrooms.
And today we were walking in the uranium mines. So tell us, what were you doing there? You were collecting...
We were collecting uranium, radioactive sources, uranium minerals, secondary uranium minerals. This is usually where we look for our food. Sources of radiation to irradiate, not just eat, but also for, outside, for our needs.
For outside and in inner, because radiation very important, and not only outside and inner radiation. This is completely different types of radiation. Irradiation from inner, like eat, incorporation, and radiation from outside.
So, let's say, what percentage of your food is radiation and what percentage is normal food?
Of course. Most percentage is of course radiation, because this is really useful substances for us that we accumulate.
80% of minimum.
So you don't have to eat.
In real, if we have enough nuclear fuel, we not have it, because our organism working principle like nuclear reactor, especially my organism. For example, I have very good like. Compare, because I was incarnation Chernobyl nuclear power plant. I like Chernobyl nuclear power plant even feel inside now. I feel that my like I have reactor inside, and I need this like nuclear fuel for it. Of course we can use normal food, but almost all our normal food is mushrooms, because we found mushrooms here. This is very good location for very radioactive mushrooms. A lot of them accumulate radioisotopes, and this is very good and very easy way to extract radioisotopes, because they have in a dissoluble form, in very good biological form, they very good like come to body. For example, about uranium minerals, we need crumble them very good, like good powder have, because because very often that we found uranium minerals, they have a lot of secondary, different complete minerals. For example, quartz. This is like sand. He completely useless for us, our organism. He like come through organism.
So your body on the Antario planet was not carbon and not silicon.
Mm-mm. And by the way, we even in body Ontario areas we eat radioactive rocks too. Mm-hmm. But we have better teeth for this before.
Uh-huh.
We have like three rada. Uh-huh. And I remember we was different because Ontario areas they not have these teeth like we have.
Mm-hmm.
There's too like little was different. Like we look like them, but little too like some features of organisms too mm-hmm. was abnormal.
So let's say if you find a nuclear waste place in big barrels, it's food for you for a year or many years.
Of course.
Well, this of course will be depends on what conditions. You see, for example, this very often we see how it looks for so-called nuclear waste. For example, this can be some metallic tubes like which little radioisotopes like mm-hmm. only contaminate them like not nuclear fuel like
a piece of iron
for example steel. Piece of iron we not eat a piece of iron for mm-hmm. example this is need special chemicals to extract them if mm-hmm. we have equipment we can do this of course but now we not have anything and best for us of course chemical reagents for example was experience in past very good. In Moscow, I eat thorium nitrate, thorium oxide, thorium uranium oxide. This was amazing powder, completely like very high quality. Even uranium 235 was percent like more than 70%. This was enrichment uranium, very good. This is real very good food. If we have, for example, this chemical reagents and we can eat, for example, one tea or big spoon per day.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I think for us, like 0.5 kilogram per month enough, and we can eat live with child food.
So if you find a nuclear bomb somewhere, it's for how long?
This is the most funny moment. For example, if somebody thinks maybe we are terrorists or something like this, we are not terrorists. If we found a nuclear bomb, we will open this and stole nuclear fuel and eat this. In this time, this will be like, we against terrorism, we like decontaminate this nuclear bomb, we eat most important thing in this bomb, and leave this metal and mm-hmm. another material.
So you can tell the Japanese that you can go to Fukushima and eat everything?
Uh-huh. No, almost everything, of course, in good nuclear fuel, of course, it's very big pleasure.
Mm-hmm.
But I think, I don't know, need, of course, if somebody invite us, we very, very much want.
Mm-hmm.
So much people write us too about this, like why we not go. Of course, why we not go? We cannot go. We not have money for this. We not have invitation for this.
Mm-hmm.
But from opposite side, even somebody invite, we don't want to put like by experimental. We want to go like free for free will, like volunteer. Mm-hmm. We can. Mm-hmm. We don't want to be like put in experimental because of this or something like this.
Mm-hmm. And you have more experiences with different kind of radiation, like electricity radiation, microwaves. So what is actually the difference between both of you? You eat more gamma radiation?
We eat exactly the same food.
Exactly the same food, but in past when we was not together.
Differences.
What you eat before?
I eat before, like, of course, from beginning, like, adapted to... We very fast adapt to normal food also, can mm-hmm. eat like humans, but mostly searched for places to irradiate, like, from outside, mm-hmm. power lines, meditations under power lines. Then microwaves, of course, too, very, very strong effects. Irradiated food, for example, in microwave, very mm-hmm. often.
So you can open your microwave oven?
And minerals, of course.
You can open a microwave oven, put head inside.
No, for head this is not interesting.
But for example, normal every food or even tea.
Oh, irradiate. This is very important. Irradiate food, irradiate tea, uh-huh. irradiate water. This is like they contain this energy. But of course, can open and put hand. This is too not so much bad.
Of course, too was later interested in mineralogy when this like was not enough for me. This energy, I knew that there is something more, and automatically like. Instinct drive towards radiation sources, mm-hmm. and of course made experiments, tried to eat it too, and find out that it really not harmful for my organism.
So I have an opposite question. What is the benefit for humanity from you? Like, what can you teach people about microwaves? Like, there is a social opinion that mobile phone radiation is harmful to brain, to humans. What can you say about it?
Well, about mobile phones is a very popular topic, of course, but this is not true. It's not harmful. Only harmful thing is this information that is inside, for example, this phone call is in this signal that is transmitted to another phone. If there is negative information inside this, of course it will act negative.
Even after they stop talking, this information like recorded in this telephone. If you call again, this even more accumulate information, even more. Who have like old mobile phones, like use it many years, of course they can accumulate a lot. But of course this depends what information in this mobile phone. The radiation, they not harmful, they only transmit information. Good, bad information.
Carriers,
the only
carriers,
like information, radiation help to go this information in brain, for example, like radiation not blaming what kind of information come through mobile phone, to which who person communicate the radiation. This is not blame of radiation.
Mm-hmm. But if someone has the tower with transmitters close to his house.
Here not. Here different effect. This effect usually acts normal, even if you can notice it under power lines, under radio towers. You notice one moment, always around, close to power lines, so big plants grow. Trees, mm-hmm. Completely, like especially like around. This is trees, they feel electromagnetic, and they feel, they even more feel healthy and grow very big like in these places. When you stand inside, you can feel this irradiation on you. Radio towers, they not so much powerful, honestly. Like they more signal come more up, mm-hmm. down, and like not have this magnetic field. This is not good for charging. Like nothing bad, but nothing good. Like more neutral. But under power lines, really very strong effect. Even if houses under power lines have, this is very powerful and energetic. Like even like protection for who live close to them.
But I heard about people, especially children, who had brain tumors. If they lived in blocks where they had the towers on the roofs.
Well, this is not because of these signals or this radiation. This is because there was probably already some damage, genetic damage.
Genetic damage, bad habits, a lot of negative factors can be. And of course, this which radiation is a very bad combination. Which radiation, which electromagnetic fields. Because radiation always show like true not only mentally, she even show true how state of organism.
Mm-hmm. So it depends.
But in the same time, radiation uses like for healing, you know, in radiotherapy,
yes.
Use for healing cancer. More stronger doses of radiation, they act healing, like they destroy cancer.
And for example,
tumors.
Radon too, radon spas, for example, healing thanks to radon. Radon is energy.
Energy is life.
Energy is life.
So, actually, it depends on the conditions that the person has inside.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
So
exactly.
And you know, usually, what I tell you, this is our experience. Usually, people who have brain tumors, exactly brain tumors, they psychic, they mm-hmm. especially like psychic pressure on other humans, like mm-hmm. true brain. But usually who have tumors,
like
they
double
have
double
personality, and they like acts on brain on other humans,
mm-hmm.
like mental violence. They like punishment for them. They have tumors after mm-hmm. that.
Okay, so what would you advise to people who live close to power lines or to the mobile phone towers? How can they change their way of thinking to benefit from those towers?
Of course, need to remove all negative factors. This is not only about this power lines, about electromagnetic fields and this kind of things. It's also about radiation, of course. This is all comes from radiation, and if they want to get benefit from it, they need to remove negative factors like can be drinking, alcohol, very dangerous, smoking, of course, nicotine. Then another, can you describe to someone?
Of course, negative thoughts, and most important, remove fear, because most first factor is if they think about this is dangerous, this will be dangerous
for them.
In any cases. They will be dangerous for them because they think already about this. They already program themselves. It's like
their
they
mind
create
is in
program
conflict
from them
automatically with this. But if they remove, then there are no barriers. Of course,
because you know, I understand. Even if this, for example, artificial power, radio towers, this are like artificial created by humans, and what a human organism. This is normal, flexible. A flexible system, he can adapt, completely normal. Now humanity not go on evolution, she go and invade the evolution. Of course, invade the evolution, human cannot adapt. He can even can more worse, and he can sick and die, and all generations will be like this. But if humanity will turn again and invade evolution, of course, he will be adapt and completely normal. It will be not harmful for them.
And what about people who had bad experiences before, like they were radiated too much with X-ray.
You mean like very high doses of radiation?
Yes.
Like
radiation
when they have radiation sickness?
Mm-hmm.
Like not like low doses, even what high doses of radiation?
Yeah, they have too much now, so how can they heal from this?
Of course, this is when they sick. This is means already organism state was before very good for creation this sickness. But human organism do have some limit to radiation definitely, but not so much like they write. For example, real limit for human started from 10 Z-words. But of course, even if humanity can adapt, maybe this limit will be even more higher. Now, of course, a very big role play vitamins in body too. These substances human use not correctly, how can use. Like, and they create his immune system and this, like, the genetically not correct work how this can be. And in very high doses of radiation, all vitamins, hormones, amino acids, they can burn inside. You can see this very, very good and directly in humans. And they have carbonated skin, dark skin, like after, like жареное, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Like some food after microwave, for example, that looks. And of course, water, water compounds, water that contain in blood, in our body, these two react to ionizing radiation. Of course, unfortunately, people have to admit to ionizing radiation because they have protium water in organism. Not deuterium, not tritium.
Mm-hmm.
Our organism, for example, they can produce deuterium and tritium inside.
Okay, so again, going back to the same question. If someone has high doses of radiation in the body,
of course, very good. In this case, when not have choice, of course, most important fact play alkaline body. Need to remove all acid environment. First, that have underhand most fast. This is natrium chloride, usual salt, normal salt, not iodine salt. Iodine salt very dangerous. Never use iodine salt. Just natrium chloride. Have some methods, for example, in intravenous injection natrium chloride in blood, or for example, soda.
Mm-hmm.
Soda, I don't know how to translate.
Mm-hmm.
This is too very good, but only in blood injection, because cannot through stomach. If soda come through stomach, completely neutralize, not any effect. But natrium chloride normal even through stomach, because this element, he not come in chemical reaction. This is not a chemical reagent. This is chemical element. He not common reaction. He good common blood and little alkaline. But this is very weak alkaline that can have anybody in his apartment. And most powerful, of course, most useful alkaline element. This is cesium. Cesium chloride. Even about this, have American researchers who discover a way to healing cancer by taking cesium chloride. This chemical reagent really very quick, very fast and very strong in alkaline body. For us, for example, cesium chloride, all reagents of cesium is very important element. For us, this is like instead of kali, potassium that a human have. But we do need potassium, potassium 40, potassium 40, mm-hmm. We need this element, but not stable potassium. Stable potassium we not tolerate. Our mostly for us, heart and all this function on cesium, potassium, potassium 40 and rubidium, rubidium 87. Uranium 235, of course, too.
Do you have any contact with your previous life friends now? Not like 10 years ago, but now. Do you communicate with them?
Not was directly contact with them, but telepathically, if you want, we can always communicate with them mm-hmm. telepathically. Mm-hmm. And I know that they often come close to Earth because they observe and they know that we are here and they like take mm-hmm. care about us. We have very good relationship with them. We help them a lot in previous incarnation. And they too like take care about us and worried. We mm-hmm. have a lot of friends. Of course, more of them already not exist, but some generations and some of them still have and they remember us very good. And of course, our spaceship, he still alive and he remember us.
Mm-hmm. So, what is your mission here on Earth for both of you?
To be here and to show, mostly of course together, to bring new wave of like knowledge to people, like awaken something inside of them.
For of course first reason why we come to Earth from Ontario Earth is completely different part of Absolute,
mm-hmm.
very big distance. And why we come in Earth? Because we have information about that anti-life creatures, our enemies that was in Ontario areas. We have information that they. Very powerful in this planet now, like very concentrated, and we go on this because we go to help. We know what we see this virus before, and we know what is it creatures, how they dangerous, and when they of course show like Earth so beautiful nature and so many beautiful beings and so disgusting creatures here. Of course we try to go to help. Of course very was a lot of like. Things on our way. We not directly come to Earth. She was contacting Plutonians, which Sirius, Siriusians, which Martians before we come to Earth.
So they want to invade Earth?
Who?
Those
anti-life creatures. No,
they already
here. They control society by these programs they create. Mm-hmm. There are many programs created by them. They control basically economic system, finances. They usually
health
like to
system.
To be at high positions, control people at high positions.
Okay, but as far as I know, they are reptilians, they are Anunnakis.
This is all illusions created by them. Mm-hmm. You can call them how you want. Demons, Anunnakis, reptilians, I don't know, like some demons. Mm-hmm. You can call how you want, but this is not this. This is all anti-life creatures. They can create any shape that you want, any form. They can be like reptile, and they can be like devil, like all. They like big like God. This is their favorite style. They try to show that they like good, and they create in the same time illusion of bad and good. Because this is not correct in all absolute not have understanding what is bad, what is good.
Mm-hmm.
This have only elements of nature, not have understand, not
yes.
not exist.
There is unity.
And,
unity.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so before I came here, I asked two of my friends to look at your aura and scan you, and they said you are clean. So tell me. How do you protect against their invasion in your aura, in your body, etheric body? this kind of...
Who protect?
Yes, of course, because of radiation. They're very afraid of
radiation. Why we have this like aura field?
Why are you clean? And other
because,
people
of course,
are not.
Of radiation. Because we completely
radiation protects from
soul.
Influence and from programming.
Our soul cannot compare with human soul. This is nothing bad. I don't want to tell anything bad to humans because this is just a different life form. When we was incarnated here, even with our soul, they never to try like invite inside us, but they try to always create pressure on us, punish us, create this society around us, because they know that we're against us, and they try to pressure on us, create. This was very big test for us before we meet.
They can influence all the outside environment.
Especially people with negative habits, negative programs are very easy for them to control. And they act through these people.
So now tell me, how can other people protect against them?
Do same thing, remove these negative factors, so they will start to see reality as it is, like remove all illusion.
Okay, this is easy to say. But
of course, but really need to do this, need to first remove, for example, fear, very important, of radiation and this kind of things, electromagnetic fields, microwaves. Another thing is remove negative factors like this drinking, smoking, alcohol. Of course, envy, like envy is very typical characteristic of anti-lives.
Oh, yeah, this is what I told you. If you not have any special abilities, what not need have for the special abilities, seeing aura or some energy fields. If you know envy, what somebody have envy, this is definitely anti-life. Even not need ask about this. This is their characteristic, or their pure characteristic. This is like open. If you know this characteristic, you see this is their definitely them.
And of course, hypocrisy when talking behind back and like spreading misinformation.
This is too negative, too very negative program from
need
them.
To remove all this, and of course. We offer our help with this. We also have like our techniques to the program, encrypted language. Thanks.
Usually we now use the encrypted language because it's language of radiation. This is most ancient language from stars, communication by between stars. This is example of this language not exist in this planet, but you can find them in tracks on a cloud chamber, for example, or in tracks on meteorites, elementary particles, how they create this shape, this language, name. Okay. For example, each mineral have name. If each radioactive mineral, when they radioactive mineral, they concentrate consciousness inside. And they have separate soul even. Of course, stones
so
have soul.
Stones communicate between each
they,
other.
They're not just stones. This is a live being that can feel. It can, for example, feel your presence.
But this
presence.
Is not inorganic life form. This is a little different. This is like concentration of a primitive soul inside. And they can come out from the stones, can even walk outside. For example, if you know what is spheroids. Spheroids like on photo camera can be some spheroids. This is, can be effect on camera like
optical effect,
optical.
But some are
like
some
orbs.
Orbs. Some of them optical effect, but some of them are real beings. And these beings usually this is souls.
You know,
stones.
2 days ago, someone asked me what are orbs. One person sent me a few pictures of orbs in her house.
Oh, we very good see what is it, because sometimes. They very good, these orbs, they very good show what environment in this house have anti-life matter in this or not. For them reaction, see very good about this environment. Sometimes even can see, sometimes in very, I see many photos when anti-life was taken photo in the moment when anti-life eat soul another human. And in this moment they can come like orb in this moment, in this moment of photo. When they eat, they just like completely see on photo how this process.
Can we talk to orbs?
Of course, communicate can communicate with them, but I think not by words. They like we not talk them by words.
By telepathy.
Telepathy, of course. If you like tune contact with them, you can
tune to same frequency. basically.
Can know from them very interesting, a lot of very interesting things about where they live, mm-hmm. for example, if they protect some prey place or something like this.
Okay, you speak your radiation language. Is this language, when you speak, is this kind of... does this influence the aura? Does it clean something? Is it...
Of course.
How useful is it?
We first just communicate between each other in this language, normal. Mm-hmm. But when we started to record videos or was some audio recording and people listen, that they tell that this is very big effect on humans. Mm-hmm. We even don't know about this, but people started to tell that we need to make more recording of this or something like this, because people have very strong effect on brain, like even the programming effect. They started realize reality after that, like some vibrations, more higher vibrations change completely. Because we create, for example, a video about harmonizer, very soon will be posted. Mm-hmm. I talk in encrypted language in this video.
Okay, so for example, say in this language, I am Zirya.
I'm going to say, "En adon Zirya Radio Renerke Keres." This is my full name.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I love you.
In Lulieren.
Okay, some more sentences, like something, I'm healing the world.
How?
I'm healing the world.
In Ulis Anirenareni.
Sounds like Hungarian, a little.
Like what?
Like Hungarian.
Mm-hmm. It is my name, and I national and this is a little vast connection with radiation dimension.
Okay. What is intuition?
Intuition? It's based on radiation. This is like ability to feel through like sixth sense.
No, intuition is like a sin, for humans is a sense like behind fringe.
Typical.
Because he like five senses physical and six senses of humans always not understand this completely what is it and tells it maybe some which is linked with chakra of course which something else but in real this is six sense this is gift from radiation. Even human have this like human cannot feel radiation by. Five senses and like we feel, but radiation like manifest by true intuition. Intuition, this is what
intuition shows true.
Intuition can show mm-hmm. you human
ability
true,
to see true and destroy illusion.
Hide inside and destroy this illusion that control.
Mm-hmm. And what about chakras? Do you have chakras?
Of course, this is in figure of speech. I mean, you know, in human body have like 7 chakras, even 8. Somebody write 12. Of course, in our body a lot of energy places, not only that right in human. Like humans have 2, but we have more of this.
But humans also have many more between the main chakras.
Mm-hmm. Our energy all connected with radiation. We have hair. A lot of energy places here, in hands because we detect by hands radiation. This is mm-hmm. like a channel to mm-hmm. connect. In legs, not so much, but in head, a lot. Everywhere.
Cerebral, a lot of anomalies
mm-hmm.
in brain.
And this behind skull, mm-hmm. this very powerful place to.
You were detecting
and also here and from backside and this is two different
like the heart chakra front and back.
Mm-hmm, this is different. Like this is not only one. This is like two,
mm-hmm.
because like here come and from here out.
In and out.
Mm-hmm.
You were detecting the radiation by hands in the mountains.
Mm-hmm. So we take dosimeter just to compare, mm-hmm. because of course we cannot, when we create video we need some improvement of mm-hmm. this. People will not understand if we not take dosimeter, for example.
Mm-hmm. Okay.